keep the secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm's coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt, they try to bring me down.
This is your man, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in this video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get this video to at least 1,500 likes, okay? That would definitely push the video to the recommended, and furthermore, if you haven't already done so, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community, as I have uploaded every single day since NBA 2K20, and I have been double uploading every single day since 2K21's prelude. So hopefully you can show appreciation for the 9 a.m. and the 4 p.m. daily uploads, and you can show those appreciations by dropping a like and subscribing, okay? Now listen, my nephews and nieces, today we're gonna talk about the two-way threats, okay? Now this build right here is also, again, one of the builds that I feel like is really, really good in the game. A lot of people have utilized this build, but I feel like a lot of people have made the build wrong. As usual, people are just maxing out categories and neglecting other categories. So it's always important to try to make your build as balanced as possible. I did go 6'7", 215 with a 7 foot, foot wingspan. Body type obviously doesn't matter, but I did kind of stay with the default attributes as far as, default physicals. And then as usual, like I always say, you do want to start off with your physicals, okay? So I'm gonna go with a 90 stamina. Let's go with a 70 vert. We want to get the strength at 61. Reason why you want to go to 61 is because it gives you, if you look on the right side, it gives you the brick wall on badge. And any attribute that activates a certain badge, I want to at least make sure I have, okay? If it makes sense for me to be a guard. You want to go with your acceleration 79 and then go 82 on your speed. And then 86 on your defensive rebound, 73 on your offensive rebound. You want to go 73 on your block, okay? Now, again, it's the same exact premise. As you see right here, when you go 74 on your block, you get the Intimidator, right? So you want to make sure you go 74 at least, because that will give you the Intimidator badge, okay? And that's something that's very important. Then with your steal, you want to go to 84. And then you're in perimeter defense, you want to go to 86. Now I'm looking, a lot of y'all are probably asking, Uncle Demi, why are you not maxing all these out? Because the fact is that you need to get your attributes distributed evenly as possible, because that just makes you have a solid all-around build. Now you do get a plus 40 of these things, so of course this 86 will get to a 90. But if you want to go ahead and make it a little bit different and tweak it, by all means, go ahead. The beautiful thing about what I'm doing for most of y'all is that I'm giving y'all more so of a cookie cutter, right? Like, I'm giving you the template, I guess you can say. That's a better way to say it. I'm giving you the template of how you can go about making some of these builds, and then you can go about it your way to make it, I guess, a better version for what you feel will be good for you, okay? And then we want to max out standing dunk. Boom, 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 boom. All right, so let me see. And then, oh yeah, we might can go. There we go. All right, so this is what I went for, and could kind of piggyback on, like I said, I'm giving y'all this setup here. Look at the badge item, 12, 12, 15, 13. It looks really, really solid all around. There's not a category that's not getting any love. Obviously, this is at a small forward position. If you wanted to go crazy with it, you can go at the power forward position and you can get more badges. But again, you know, a lot of people were saying why everything's at a power forward. I want to stress again, guys, this is positionless basketball now. There is not a position. If you look at your player card, or when you're playing in the park, or you're playing in a rec and that type of deal, when your player card pulls up, it does not have a position beside it. So if you remember, look in your park. Just think about when you play in the park. Next time you go in the park and you're walking, you know, about to play, and it shows y'all builds and stuff, let me know if there's a position. That's why everybody's making power forwards, okay? Because you get the best badge attributes, and you can be 6'7", 215, 7 foot wingspan, and you have even more badges than what you currently have here, okay? But now remember, now you do get a plus 4 to everything. So you're looking at a 99 driving dunk, 97, driving layup. You're looking at a 98 mid-range shot, a 93 three ball, 84 pass accuracy, 88 ball handle, 85 speed with ball, a 90 perimeter defense, 88 steal, a 78 block, 77 offensive rebound, a 90 defensive rebound, 86 speed, 83 acceleration, 66 strength, 74 vert, and 94 stamina, okay? So again, the build is well solid. It can speed boost, it can shoot, it can dunk, it can play defense, it can rebound. I did not touch the interior defense. If you do want to do something with interior defense, I will recommend that you stay within here, but do not touch your block and your steal, because those are, you know, as you said, you drop your block down one, you see your intimidator goes away. So there's a way that you want to work about this, but you do want to keep your intimidator. So work that way. But again, like I said, interior defense is good, but at the same token, let your centers take care of that, right? And then here for the takeovers, obviously with the two-way threat, to me personally, I think having the extreme clamps and then of course the easy blow bys. You can flip it, flop it, whichever way you want, but that's what I would go with. And then here you have it, my nephews and nieces, the two-way threat, shades of Scottie Pippen at the top. That is probably one of the best two-way players of all time. He's easily one of the top five best two-way players of all time. That's not even without a doubt. And it's pretty good to have him up there. I don't know how Gordon Hayward and TJ Warren's in there, but that's for another story. Let's go ahead and test this build out real quick. Let's give him the 99. Of course, we will get you out of here, okay? Now, again, what you want to do is, of course, you want to get Posterizer. I feel like Posterizer is the most important badge, as usual, when it comes to finishing. Next, we would go with the Fearless Finisher. We also want to go with Slithery Finisher. And then the last one, of course, you can go, well, for me, I'm going to go with Put Back Boss and Rise Up. I know that might sound crazy, but I like the bronze badges. I like the Rise Up, which makes it easier to dunk under the basket. It's such a game-changing badge. A lot of people have slept on that, but it works really well, especially on the contact. So that's what I will rock with. And again, like I tell you all the time, my nephews and nieces, this is up to you. You can make this build any way you want. I mean, the badge lineup too, okay? Of course, Hot Zone Hunter, again, as usual, is still going to be very OP. If you're a primary ball handler, obviously you want to get primary ball handling shooting. If you are going to be a secondary ball handler, stay in the corner where that, then of course you want to get the catch and shoot, corner specials, that type of deal. But let's treat this build as if it's going to be a primary ball handler. You want to go with Hot Zone Hunter, Hot Shot, and then of course deep threes. These three right here are going to be very important for a primary ball handler type build. And the next I was go blinders on bronze, just for those contested shots that come up to the side. And then here, of course, you want to go with your quick first step. You want to go with your handles for days. Here we go. Your handles for days. Bailout, bullet passer on silver. That's very important. Ankle breaker, space creator, and then unpluckable. Okay. And again, like I said, I'm just going different routes. You can do this any way you want. Clamps, you want to go intimidator, rim protector, chase down artist. Where you at? There you go. Interceptor on silver, and then where's you at? Clutch defender, okay? On gold. But anyway, there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the two-way threat. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon with another banger, man. And you know, when I say back soon with another banger, you already know damn talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.